Akroora's message. Akroora was indeed very pleased that he had been chosen to convey the message to Vraja. His joy knew no bounds at the thought that at last he would see the lotus feet of the Lord. He felt sure that despite the message he was carrying, the Lord would know of his deep devotion to him and therefore would forgive him all his sins. All along the way to Vraja, his mind was absorbed in Krishna, and he rehearsed in his mind how he would fall at his feet when he met him, how he would raise him and embrace him, etc. Akroora reached Vraja just as the sun was setting. Krishna and Balarama, refreshed after a bath, were strolling in the courtyard where the cows were being milked. There was a lovely fragrance of fresh sandal paste about them, and they wore neat, clean clothes of blue and yellow. Gems sparkled at their throats, and their chests were adorned with garlands of wild flowers. In great excitement at beholding the beautiful shining face of the Lord, Akroora jumped down from his chariot and was overwhelmed with joy. The tears rolled freely down his cheeks as he fell at the feet of Krishna and prostrated before him. His voice was choked with emotion, which prevented him from saying who he was, where he had come from, and for what purpose. Gently, Krishna raised him to his feet and embraced him warmly. Balarama too embraced him and greeted him affectionately. Then the brothers took him inside. They made him comfortable. They washed his tired feet and massaged them and fed him a delicious meal. Then Nanda and Akroora exchanged greetings. While they were talking, Akroora told them how Narada had come to Kamsa and revealed to him the secret of Krishna's birth. He also told them the real reason why he had been sent to Vraja. At this, Krishna and Balarama laughed heartily. Nanda ordered at once that the carriages and presents be got ready for their trip to Mathura. He had it proclaimed throughout Vraja that early the next morning they would proceed to Mathura to witness the great bow sacrifice. The next morning, as the sun crept over the horizon, Akroora offered his prayers. The boys climbed onto his carriage. Slowly, the carriages and carts started moving towards Mathura. Akroora's chariot was followed by the chariots of Nanda and the other gopas. Behind them came the carts loaded with gifts of milk, curd and butter for Kamsa. And the gopis, who can describe the sorrow they felt at the separation from their Lord? Their hearts were numb and heavy with grief. They followed the carriages with heart-rending pleas. They wept and ran behind the chariots for a long distance. They bade the brothers farewell and for a long time watched after the carriages even after they had disappeared from sight. They felt limp and forlorn, like creepers whose support has been taken away. Back in Vraja, the gopis went about their work as usual, but their minds were fixed on Krishna. When they were together, they spoke of his deeds and glories and sang songs in his praise. When they were alone, they meditated deeply upon the divine nature of the Lord.